7:34 and covering world news now. This morning, King Abdullah of Jordan is vowing to wage a harsh war against ISIS in Syria. And now the Pentagon says the U.S. military will do more to help Jordan in that fight. Susan McGinnis reports from Washington, D.C.
A video apparently showing Jordanian pilot Moath Al-Kassesba being burned alive has sparked a new offensive against ISIS. CBS News has learned the Pentagon will deploy search and rescue helicopters in northern Iraq to reach downed pilots faster. Al-Kassesba ended up in enemy hands after his fighter plane crashed in Syria in December.
The simple fact of the matter is that we were not in a position to locate the pilot before he was picked up by ISIL forces.
The U.S., along with Jordan and other coalition forces, have kept up air strikes against the terror group in Iraq and Syria, conducting more than a dozen in recent days.
This is a moment where the brutality of what ISIS has demonstrated is really not winning them many followers in the moderate Sunni Arab states, and certainly has galvanized Jordan to fight against them.
As Jordan considers sending in ground troops to fight ISIS, members of Congress are calling on the White House to boost military aid to the country. Republicans and Democrats want the Obama administration to move quickly to provide aircraft parts, night vision equipment, and other weapons to Jordan.
We certainly are interested in maintaining the strong military-to-military and national security ties that we have with that country.
The White House says the president would consider any aid package put forward by Congress, but is looking for a specific request from Jordan's government. Susan McGinnis, CBS News, Washington.
The U.S. is already providing Jordan with $1 billion in military and economic aid this year.